tale begins as Pippin's childhood ends. His last day at the University of Padua, where his father had sent him.
So that he may embark upon his life as a maximum of choices.
And possibilities.
So distinguished that university that the faculty bestowed upon him the special title of
Scholar of the House.
And Pippin responded in his own deeply moving words of, he may be a little nervous. This is his first time playing the role.
Could I have some more lights, please?
Okay, I guess he's not that nervous.
Thank you, gentle tutors, respected members of the faculty. I'm very grateful for the knowledge you have given me, but I'm afraid what I'm looking for can't be found in books.
And Pippin made a promise.
A promise not to waste my life on commonplace, ordinary pursuits. I'm gonna live a life that's extra ordinary. I know there is something, but I can't quite find a word for it.
Something fulfilling, something completely fulfilling.
That's it. Something completely fulfilling. And I'm gonna find it. I don't know where or how. Everything has its season, everything has its time. Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can't run free.
No,
not all of that crap yet. What is it?
Well, sire, due to a famine, my fields are barren.
Denied. Next.
Sire?
Denied.
But, sire, I must protest. This is unjust and tyrannical.
Take this man away and hang him.
You can't do that.
You know what? Out! Out! Everybody, out!
Oh, wait, sire.
I said everybody out.
Father, it's me, Pippin.
Pippin, no! My boy! What are you doing here?
Oh, I'm home. I already finished school.
Ready. Well, how was it?
Oh, very well, Father. Some of my tutors came.
Oh, good, good. I'm a great believer in education.
And yet, you've become the most powerful man in the world.
The most powerful man in the world? What about the Pope, Pippin?
I rank ahead of the Pope, sir.
And I happen to agree with you. Pippin, good to see you.
Wait, Father.
You know, we have a library now. Perhaps you can take out a book.
Thank you.
After all, tomorrow is for you.
But it's still today.
Yes. But for how long, Pippin? You'll see. Sunrise and sunset. They are similar, but they are not identical.
Father, what does that even mean?
Enter Lewis. Pippin's half-brother, and after Pippin, heir to the throne. Addicted to the physical, Lewis loves weightlifting. Lewis loves wrestling. But most of all, Lewis loves Lewis.
Ha! Did you go?
Well done, brother.
Of course it was. You know, this army tricked the Frisians last year, and we're going to slay even more Visigoths.
You're going to war against the Visigoths?
That's the next one. It's going to be a glorious campaign, and... those Visigoth women, I don't want to shock your bookish sensibilities, but...
I'm only shocked you're interested in women now.
Enter the strike.
Pippin's stepmother. Crafty. Cunning. Calculating.
But a warm and wonderful mother.
Dedicated to gaining the throne for her darling son, Lewis.
Lewis. Lewis dear, mommy has for you.
Thank you, mother. Think how I'll shine. And look at this. Isn't it a beauty?
Really is beautiful.
Of course it's beautiful. Lewis is a wonderful warrior.
Ha!
Did you go? Aren't we so proud, Lewis dear?
Yeah.
Oh, before I forget, the royal treasurer appointment overdrawn my allowance account.
You're overdrawn again?
Now, my lord. You know how hard it is for me, for I am just an ordinary housewife. Just like all you ordinary housewives and mothers out there.
You know, sometimes I wonder if the fornicating I'm getting is worth the fornicating I'm getting.
Father, I know what I want to do now.
Oh, good, good. What is it?
I want to be a soldier.
What? Denied.
But, Father, I'm the son. Well, that means I'll be king one day, and fighting wars is an important part of being king, isn't it?
Yes, fighting wars is a very important part of being king. After all, Pope and I have dedicated ourselves to spreading Christianity throughout the entire world, even if we have to kill every known Christian to do it.
Exactly, so I want to join the campaign against the Visigoths.
Denied.
But that's not fair, you're taking Lewis.
Yes, well, your brother Lewis is an ideal warrior. He's strong, he's stupid. You, on the other hand, are educated.
And for what? Father, you're dedicated to something extraordinary. I just want to be dedicated to something, too, with all my heart and soul. Otherwise, my life, it won't have any meaning at all.
Oh, well, I see. You want your life to have meaning.
Yes, I do.
Well, that's very ambitious of you, Pippin. Denied.
But, Father...
Denied.
Father, you created an entire kingdom out of nothing. Now I just want my chance to fight for my family, for my country, and, well, for my king.
Well, Oh, all right. Get yourself a decent helmet and come along.
A soldier.
Yes. Yes, you are.
Me, a warrior. Finally, a chance to use something important. A chance to use my sword, my arm, and me, even my blood.
praise be to Charles our Lord. Triumphant is his sword. Allegiance is his word. Glory, glory. Glory, glory. Look!
Pippin both did very well. Well, now we plunder and pillage. It is required, and singing is essential to victory. And then the men jump up, sing, Pippin, you're not joining in. All two men, give thanks to God for granting us this victory.
I guess it's really the one who happened to this one. Dying in a battle like this, you would be going to Valhalla or wherever you infidels go.
Oh, absolutely, the king has assured us personally. But this way around's gonna be a bit edgy.
This wasn't your first battle, was it?
No, my third.
Oh, well, then maybe you could tell me. How was this battle compared to your other two?
Well, unless you get killed, one battle is pretty much like another.
I was afraid you'd say that. Get to Valhalla soon.
Hope you get to heaven.
Oh, I will.
Pippin, this is embarrassing. A victory celebration and my own son's not joining in.
Sorry, God. I'm about to get used to victory celebrations without me. I thought there'd be more blooms.
Enter brother exiled from court.
Due to a personality conflict with her daughter-in-law.
Grandma.
Oh, I hate me a point.
Ah, but you're so good at it.
Pippin? Pippin! Oh, Pippin, I can't believe it. How good it is to see you again. And hoping I made you soon.
Oh, Grandma, you look great.
No, I don't. I look terrible.
No, you look great.
No, I don't. I look terrible.
All right, fine. You look terrible.
Is that any way to speak to your lovely grandmother? What, seriously, Pippin?
I'm sorry.
You look terrible. You need some fresh air, some more food, maybe some acupuncture.
Oh, Grim, I don't know what I need.
Oh, I know what I need. Some good, juicy gossip. You gotta tell me what's going on at court. Is Estrada still leading your father on by the nose?
Grandma, you haven't changed a bit.
Oh, but you have Pippin. What have you been doing with yourself?
Well, I went to war.
That explains it.
I tried to own my own man, you know? I tried to get my blood back, do something important, something meaningful, but that wasn't it. Now I just feel empty and vacant. So I think I need a goal. A goal and a plan. Well, I have a goal. I want to be fulfilled. But a good plan, that's what I've been thinking about. I can't just sit around wasting time and hope something falls into my lap. But on the other hand, I can't just sit here and expect something to just sort of, I don't even know.
Yeah, you lost me in the middle there, Pippin. Stop thinking. You think too much. We want to live in the moment. I mean, look at this day. Look at it. The sun is shining. The air is warm. And maybe tonight, down at the tavern, we'll find a lovely young woman who could hook up with and do all those fun things you cool kids do, and then you can come back to me and tell me everything you've got in detail.
Oh, Grandma, I don't have time for that.
Time? Now, Pippin, you sit down. I know all about time. When you are as old as I, my dear, and I hope that you never are, you will woefully wonder why, my dear, your cataracts and tar. You could squander away or sequester a drop of a precious year, for when your best spit out your teeth with the seeds. Before it's too late, stop trying to wait for fortune and fate you're secure of. For there's one thing to be sure of, mate. There's nothing to be sure of. Oh, it's time to start living. Time to take a little from the world we're given. Time to take time, for spring will turn to fall. There's just no time at all.
Grandma, it's time that I'm worried about.
I told you already. Sit down. I have 3 more courses to do. You're welcome to join in if you like. And that goes for all. never had told. Maybe you'll understand why. I believe if I refuse to grow old, I can stay young till I die.
Take that!
I don't know if I need to. Oh, okay.
Thank you.
fun to me what you were doing there.
But it wasn't fulfilling. Why can I find anything to do with fulfilling?
Look, we just got started. There's a lot of things you can try.
Like what?
Like taking a look at this.
Peasants revolt. King slays thousands, slaughtered yesterday by Charlemagne's soldiers. What? That can't be true.
Nah. Would a newspaper print anything that wasn't true?
My father would never slaughter innocent people just for protest.
Why not? He's the king. Huh? Today, Charlemagne has given orders that non-believers be given the chance between baptism or beheading.
Wait a minute. Forcing people to believe, telling them what to think? Something's got to be done about this.
Well, you're absolutely right.
It's time for a change.
Damn it! It's time for a change.
You know, it doesn't matter that he's my father. I'm starting to see him for who he really is. He forces people to fight and die over land that doesn't even belong to him.
Testing, testing.
But if we don't take action now, one day we'll look around and ask ourselves what happened. What happened if we failed to act?
Are you on, testing?
It's time for a better world for all. Not just the rich and powerful. This tyrant must be overthrown. Yeah! Power and bloodshed must be ended. We need a new leader to speak out with a new order. Yeah! Down with Charles, up with me. Yeah!
Revolution!
Beloved husband's life, I brought Pippin's activities to his attention. Pippin is disloyal to you, my lord.
Every son is disloyal to his father at one point or another, my lady.
But Louis loves you, my lord.
Louis is an imbecile, my lady.
Despite this rejection, I took upon my tiny shoulders a task of rapprochement between two men whom I felt.
Thank you. I'm sorry to disturb you, my son.
You know who I am?
Of course, my son.
You want something from me. Perhaps a favor, advancement?
I'm here to be with you one moment, my son, to look into your eyes.
What do you see?
I see two eyes, a little cloudy with age, the sun is gone.
What else?
I see the death of thousands, the slavery of more, terror and bloodshed.
You see all of that in my eyes.
Do you deny it?
Tonight. I'm proud of it. I brought order out of chaos, of terror and bloodshed when necessary to achieve that order, so be it.
Those are words from the past. Time has passed you by, my son.
And your time has come.
Yes, father.
My son. You know, it's so easy from where you stand to judge the things that I've done. Eagles, ospreys, even vultures had a better view. From the heights, all things seem very clear. But when I marched, the dust of the road was in my mouth. And when I fought, the blood of the enemy in my eye. But by God, I blew my breath across a continent and shaped an empire with it.
Father, maybe you did what you thought was best, but things have to change.
And you're going to be the one to change them?
Yes, I am.
Well then, if you so truly believe that, I suppose there's only one thing you can do.
Thank you. I brought my own.
Then use it. Or go. Just leave me to my prayers.
Father, what do you pray for?
Strength. May God give you the same.
Morning glow is long.
of your lives.
There will now be a brief 15 minute intermission. Don't forget to put in for the 50-50 raffle.
Thank you.
No, that's completely unfair, but I will do something about it. I hereby decree that peasants shall own the land they cultivate.
King Pippin, the just.
Oh, well then, I abolish taxes!
King Pippin, the generous.
Oh, right. Good point. So, no more taxes, no more army.
King Pippin, the peaceful.
It is my duty to inform you that the infidel Hun has attacked in the east. He destroyed 3 villages and murdered thousands of your royal subjects.
Can he do that?
But he will withdraw on one condition.
Well, that's very reasonable. What's the condition?
He demands your reproductive organs on a pike staff.
Well, then go out there and destroy the infidel.
But you have no arms. She doesn't have
mic. Oh, right. Peasant?
Yes, sire?
I hereby suspend land reform.
Suspend land reform? You mean give it back?
That's right, give it back.
I'm blind, sire! Yes.
Take that man away and hang him!
No,
wait, no, stop, please, just let me think a minute.
Nothing has changed since your father left. Now, about my royal allowance?
Denied.
Unpopular.
I need to pray.
Pray? Why, you're the king. What in the world would you pray?
Strength.
Is there anything else you'd like?
Yeah, I'd like my knife back.
You want it? You got it.
Thank you.
guards are usually first to go.
Pippin dedicated himself to the church, the religious life. He longed to be touched by an angel. But what he found was...
It wasn't an angel who touched me.
When things get jangly,
I'm just a plane. challenge. I was determined to somehow pierce that dedicated apathy. Now I found that no one, no matter what his condition, can resist the charm of a growing boy. So I sent my son Theo to him.
Enter Theo. A lovable boy and his lovable duck.
Pippin, sail in my duck.
Guess his name.
Augustus.
Wrong, his name's Otto. You're not very smart.
A duck belongs in a pond and not in my bed.
Bite me!
Pippin, you've been lying in this bed for 7 days now. What is the matter with you?
Nothing you could possibly understand.
Well, try me.
All right. Try just about everything I can think of. Find something fulfilling, but I haven't even been close. So I'm an utter abject, complete despair.
Yeah. And that's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Pippin, let me tell you something about despair. I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then one day he was struck with fever. And when his hand went cold in mine, I felt my life too was over. I was overcome by the deepest despair. I took to my bed for 5 days. But on the sixth day I got up. There were things to be done, an estate to run, a boy to raise. Pippin, this is such a large estate. I'm all alone here and I can't do all this work by myself. Can you please help me?
Wait! Wait a minute. You're supposed to read the line, naggingly.
Yeah, but he put his hand on my face. They don't usually do that.
I don't care where he put his hand. Read it, naggingly. Look, you're almost too old to be playing this role, right? So you better watch it. I got my eye on you.
Size of the compost heap when you're extraordinary. You gotta do extra.
then Peter's stuff got sick. Pippin, Otto is sick.
Oh, Theo, I'm sorry.
Pippin, come on. It's the first time he's come to you for help. Can you look at him, please?
All right, come here. Theo, there's nothing I can do.
Come on, Pippin, try.
Well, this is a very sick duck. No, I'm sorry. There's nothing to do. All right, wait a minute. Come here. Kneel down next to me.
It was like a painting. Man and boy and duck and prayer.
His head is pulse is long. His feet are wet, but even so, you must know that although our tears are poised to burst, we kept our faith warm through the worst. We haven't cursed our luck or run amok. To prayer we've stuck. Please reward our
luck
and see these stuck.
They prayed all day, and then, just after sunset, the duck died.
I'm sorry. Why did the damn duck have to die?
And then an interesting thing happened. Theo plunged himself into monumental despair, while Pippin, the prince of despair, dedicated himself to raising the boy's spirits.
Hey, Theo, we're going out to rest and pray, so we can use another good bit. Another time, maybe.
But Pippin, with remarkable persistence, tried yet another way.
Hey, Theo, you're not going to believe what I got for you. If you want, I can teach you how to.
Well, most men would have given up, but Pippin, with remarkable perseverance, tried yet another way.
Hey, Theo, you're not going to believe what I got for you. On the count of three, you can turn around and look. One, two, three.
That's not a duck, stupid.
Did I say it was a duck? Yeah, go on, you are a flop.
Sitting on the floor and talking till the dawn.
scandals and confidences.
Trading old beliefs and humming old songs.
And lowering old defenses.
Singing a
struck with fever.
Run free.
When his hand went cold in mine.
God,
Thank you. I guess I'll miss the man. Explain it if you can. His face was far from fine.
What are you doing?
But still I'll miss his face. And wonder if he's missing mine.
You don't have a song here.
I do now. Some days he wouldn't say a pleasant word all day. Some days he'd scowl and curse. But there were other days when he was really even worse.
I really think you should stop singing.
Some men are heroes, some men outshine the sun, some men are simple good men. This man wasn't one, and I won't miss his moods, his creamy solitudes, his blood.
Think about the sun.
the world up well. Now it's your chance, and the glory and the splendor inviting you to dance. Think about the sun. Think how you'll shine.
Like the glow of the morning.
You will burn in our memories forever.
Forever!
Think about your life today.
Days were tame and nice to say.
Think about the beauty in one perfect play. And the danger of
Thank you.
color I can have on earth that won't finally fade.
Understanding? Do you know how much he's gonna cost you?
What I want it worth to pay.
Is this what you really want?
Costumes to
wear. No costumes, no sets?
Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky.
Oh, gentlemen, don't forget about the 50-50 raffle.
That's what we're coming out here to do right now. Miss Fabra. Oh! Oh, hi! Michael!
That's my mom.
And the lucky winner is number 6, 3, 2, 4, 1, 4.